In America on a Virginia plantation, Tom Molineaux was emerging as America's first great boxer. His enslaver would bet large sums of money that Molineaux would always win fights. On one huge fight, it is said that he bet the entire plantation. Molineaux won the fight and was granted his freedom. Tom Molineaux went to New York and for 5 years defeated all challengers anywhere in the nation and internationally. Soldiers told him that the heavyweight championship of the world would be determined in London, England. Molineaux got on a ship and went to London. His first few fights, Molineaux just demolished British fighters, and it was determined that he had to be met by Tom Cribb, the heavyweight champion of the world. On December 18, 1810, the fight of the century was set up. All British nobility was there, and they could not envision that this American from those colonies would defeat the British at their national sport. Tom Cribb won that fight, but many historians have argued ever since that Molineaux was cheated and should have been declared the champion. Molineaux knocked Tom Cribb down, and Cribb could not come back to scratch to the center of the ring within the 30 seconds allotted. His corners yell, "Foul, foul, he has rocks in his hands." So they stopped and investigated. Molineaux had no rocks, but they gave Tom Cribb time to recuperate. Later, Tom Cribb won that fight, but Molineaux had legitimized athletics in America, nationwide and internationally.